And I'm also pleased that you are such a vibrant community now, that you are galvanizing the women of Balochistan, of Quetta. You belong to different walks of life, and this is such a great feat to watch, that you have engaged people, particularly our women community across the board, whether they are professionals, whether they are in government services or in private sector. You are connecting with them, and you are trying to highlight their problems. Indeed, Balochistan is a work in progress in many ways in giving a space to our women and youth particularly. This is something that one area we need to work in a big way. I really admire your leadership, that you are already working on this goal. Yes, you are working, in Quetta, but, the women population in Balochistan now coming up, they want to be part of the active society. They want to join services. They want to join the private sector. Yesterday, I went to a convocation in Balochistan University. Probably 40 to 50% of our, students, they were, our female students. I went to Makran, division or belt. I was amazed at the women participation in educational institutions, probably again 40 to 50%. So you can see that, our future is our women, their education is increasing to the level that they are competing with our male population. However, they don't have the equal space to operate. They don't have a equal opportunity to be part of the private sector or the government sector. It is, I have seen so many talented women that they struggle to have this sifarish, and they get jobs. If it were merit, they would have been appointed. But it's a sorry state of affairs that, appointments are made on political and ethnic basis, not on merit, not on something that, we have these expertise in the house, whether a male or female. This is something that is unacceptable, and we have to speak against. If Balochistan has to move forward, we need to introduce a merit at every level, a merit at the government, jobs, and also we need to give this social space to our women so that they can operate and work. It's again pity. In my civil secretariat, where I am a minister, I saw there were no facilities available to our women, colleagues, staff working in the civil secretariat, and I saw there were no, I'm sorry to say that, proper toilets, facilities, their access was restricted. And so that sort of environment is still exists in the government departments. So that needs to create an awareness. Now, having said that, I would request you as well that it should not be alone your fight. You connect with other organizations. I would love to see, the women NGO, Aurat Foundation, which is working in Balochistan for the last few decades, I reckon. So you need to connect with them. I don't know, our, welfare department, the women, officers, they are quite vibrant. I visited them. They are working on so many things. I'm sure you have connected with them as well, but utilize them in a big way so that your voice is amplified, and also make sure that whatever organizational capacity and prowess you have it today, that is also extended to other parts of Balochistan. I know it's easy for me to say that you have to be leading from the front, not only, in Quetta, but also in other parts of Balochistan. However, since you have this leadership, who have got this determination, vision to connect with women population, I'm sure that you can do more than that. You can also expand to other parts of Balochistan. Women population in the other parts of Balochistan, they are struggling. they need some sort of vision, they need some sort of encouragement, they need inspiration, they want to see models, and you are the role models working as well as you are highlighting the rights of women. This is something that I really admire, that despite whatever commitments you have it in terms of jobs, in terms of family, in terms of social engagements, yet you have highlighted a boring job in that sense, which is a thankless job. You have this idealism that you want to change the space for women to come out and also exercise their right to be there. This is a great job indeed, but I can assure you that we have to start from somewhere. You have to struggle, and it has to be started from somewhere, and you have already started it. This is very impressive. When I was asked to come to this function on Sunday, I simply said, okay, please, I'm unwilling to come, and where shall I come? Because I really wanted to inspire you, that you have come this far, and if a government minister is not available just because he want to enjoy this Sunday, this is something, a disrespect to your struggle, a lack of appreciation to your leadership, and also all the members who have come along on Sunday, leaving behind your families, your kids, your other commitments. I was coming in, and my kid, she was saying that where you are going, I will be. I said, come over, it's a great family function. So this is my honor, as I said already, that I'm here today. But I just want to make sure that the two passions that I have it, we have already announced a women's summit on 27th of this month, inshallah, in Governor House. I would invite you as well to be there, so you connect with others.